Yeah.
See,
and I went like this and just hit right.
Could you call Billy? Or call Kathy up there? Like you have third generation Bill Thomas next to that thing.
Yeah, but where is she? She's not home. She's at that party.
Well, they might be done with it by now.
No one cats it, Sean.
You got the phone or not?
No, I don't. You took it in this way. No, I don't know. For a few minutes, then I put
it. That's
the same. Unless she told me.
I didn't want to change it.
Oh, yes.
She told me.
They probably just started throwing it together and said, oh, that looks good, let's do that.
Exactly where they looked at.
We had to say, no, we can't do that. That's not right. Well, that don't fit right.
Yeah, gotcha.
I'm proud of it. I really am.
What's the wheel?
What?
Wheel base.
90.
Yeah, it's right on. Let's see, I think it's red from about 58.
The front is
back to 58. Huh? 62. They're wider. Wider track in the front. I know we have other wider track. I got some, I told you I had that book, that report from Chevrolet. I looked for it, couldn't find it, but I'll find it, really. And it's got all the specs that they test.
That would be interesting to see.
The lateral acceleration was way up there when it did that.
Well, the driver that wrote that little article, when he, John Roberts, when he drove it around the corner, he said it felt like the car was on rails because it would handle around the corner so well. He had a problem every time he wanted to throttle it, the tires would break loose, no matter where he was at in RPM. And that's what gave him the problem. The tires in the rear just kept breaking loose everywhere. That was a different motor, and he got thrown in the tri-power, not this setup. But I had real skinny tires in the back, and I went with bigger tires, did some adjustment on the suspension.
Well, those tires on the rear are used up now anyway.
No, they're brand new.
They are brand new?
Yeah, they're brand new.
Now, what do you, now those are brand new made for?
That's for vintage racing.
Okay.
That's
SCCA. Yeah, I mean, it's not something.
No. Actually, that's not even a legal street tire. They're not even DOT approved. But I'm not going to tell you.
Let's put the hood down.
Good friends, Bob. Hey, Bob Oxford, this is Rick Holmes.
There's John. Look how big John is.
Yeah, he's friendly today, too.
There's Hollis, the world. They're not the world, but it's one of them.
Okay.
What's on?
I'm so tipped like me.
Oh, you know what?
Coming from you, that means something, believe it or not.
Well, you know, you talk about the guy said didn't have it. You know, Sayer was in the national championship.
64 and 5.
You know, this thing held a straightaway record out at
Elkhart Lake.
Elkhart Lake for
11 years. Yeah. And it hit 215 at Daytona one year. But people don't believe it.
Yeah, with 205 miles an hour.
That's fast back then. What else could touch it then?
Yeah, well, Frank Winchell from Chevrolet was out there. You know, Chevrolet had all the automobiles designed in that track. And Frank Winchell was out here, and he said, "No, I don't understand. This is a faction of and he was timed because they come out turn 8 and someplace down there, both in and then in turn 9. So his time was a watch. If you're down 5 miles an hour coming out of the turn, you're stuck.
Right.
You want to pop the hood again?
This car might be closer than
some of those original hoods. If it's closer than this,
that's tough to do.
Well, we made this off of the first two you made. A lot of it's off the first two.
Yeah.
And everything changed after that.
We were changing all the time.
Through the whole program.
We laid the radiator down.
But you know what? The few guys that own the original ones, the only thing they're worried about, 10 years from now, somebody's going to pull it out of the garage and say it's one of yours. That's what they're worried about. Because if you put 10 years of use on it, it's going to look like an original car then. Because it's that close.
Yeah, well, it's just like we were down at a kid that worked with me, his daughter graduated from high school, and he worked for Dan Gurney as a
I don't know if any of the pictures you got, you'll see a sideboard box with the duct tape on.
That was the FIA supercar.
Oh, yeah?
They had to be able to fit it. And see, and ours had a spare tire.
Right. Which I felt today you really don't need. I just left that out. We had to have it. It was the rules.
Right.
But in today's standards,
oh, that's all right. Now you got to give him your piece.
Did you want to get your 60 second out?
Yeah.
I got to get a little bit.
close enough.
Yeah, they had to guess.
Right.
It's great. We made the adjustments.
Right.
The grocery store.
There's some ladies that's something good about it.
I love people like that.
That's what I'm telling you. I think screen tolerance.
Right,
because
the village.